Revelation.
We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, in this Eucharistic celebration, let us pray for the safety of everyone. And to those who are following us online, be safe and stay dry. Let us ask the Lord to spare us of further danger and further damage because of this typhoon. To make ourselves less unworthy of this Eucharistic celebration, let us acknowledge that we are all sinners and that we need God's pardon and mercy. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy.
And grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, to whose commands all the elements give obedience, we humbly entreat you that the stilling of fearsome storms may turn a powerful menace into an occasion for us to praise you. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. A reading from the beginning of the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The words of Jeremiah, son of Hilkiah, of a priestly family in Anathoth, in the land of Benjamin. The word of the Lord came to me thus, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I dedicated you, a prophet to the nations, I appointed you. Ah, Lord God, I said, I know not how to speak, I am too young. But the Lord answered me, say not, I am too young. To whomever I send you, you shall go. Whatever I command you, you shall speak. Have no fear before them, because I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord. Then the Lord extended his hand and touched my mouth, saying, see, I place my words in your mouth. This day I set you over nations and over kingdoms, to root up and to tear down, to destroy and to demolish, to build and to plant. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will sing of your salvation.
I will sing of your salvation.
In you, O Lord, I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your justice, rescue me and deliver me. Incline your ear to me and save me.
I will sing of your salvation.
Be my rock of refuge, a stronghold to give me safety. For you are my rock and my fortress. O my God, rescue me from the hand of the wicked.
I will sing of your salvation.
For you are my hope, O Lord, my trust, O God, from my youth. On you I depend from birth, from my mother's womb. You are my strength.
I will sing of your salvation.
My mouth shall declare your justice, day by day your salvation. O God, you have taught me from my youth. Until the present, I proclaim your wondrous deeds.
I will sing of your salvation. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On that day, Jesus went out of the house and sat down by the sea. Such large crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat down, and the whole crowd stood along the shore. And he spoke to them at length in parables, saying, A sower went out to sow. And as he sowed, some seed fell on the path, and birds came and ate it up. Some fell on rocky ground where it had little soil. It sprang up at once because the soil was not deep. And when the sun rose, it was scorched. And it withered for lack of roots. Some seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it. But some seed fell on rich soil and produced fruit, 100, 60, or 30-fold. Whoever has ears ought to hear. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good afternoon. In this morning's Mass at 7:30, there were about 8 people who attended the Mass. And now, there are only 4. I'm not counting my staff and the security guards. Are you living nearby? Are you living in Intramuros? And how about the 3 of you? Are you Filipinos? A foreigner? Okay, welcome to Manila. See, enjoy the typhoon. Eh? Our gospel for today is a familiar gospel. It's the parable of the sower. And this parable teaches us many things about life. This method of farming, with this method of farming, the sower knows that not all seeds will fall on good soil. If you put it mathematically, the parable is telling that 3/4 of the seeds fell on unhealthy soil. Only 1/4 became fruitful. But the interesting thing is this, even if the sower knows that not all seeds will fall on good soil, he continues sowing. Hindi niya sinasabi na, ano ba naman to? Hindi naman lahat ng tinatanim ko nagbubunga. Hindi naman lahat ng mga binhi na itinatanim ko ay nagbubunga. Eh, hinto na lang ako sa pagsasaka. Hinto na lang ako sa paghahasik. Hindi niya sinabi yon. Sapagkat alam niya na kahit paano may mahuhulog na binhi sa mabuting lupa. The farmer or the sower does not quit sowing. Even he knows that not all seeds will fall on good soil. He keeps on sowing. And my dear sisters and brothers, it has a very important lesson in life. Not all the things that we'll do will be successful. Some of the people will fail in the exam, in the board, in the bar. Some will not get admitted to their desired university. Some will not be approved in his or her application for visa. Some will not find the job that he wants or she wants. Not all the efforts that we do will be rewarded with success. But the message of the gospel is this: do not quit. Do not quit. Even if you're experiencing failure, do not stop striving, because the next may be your successful story. One quotation that we know in English is this, no? If at first you don't succeed, try and try again. Kahit paano, gagantimpalaan ang ating pagsusumikap. I remember a poem, the title is Don't Quit. And the first stanza of the poem written by John Whittier goes like this: when things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road dredging seems all uphill, when the funds are low and the debts are high, and you want to smile, but you have to sigh, when care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Huwag kang susuko, huwag kang hihinto, sapagkat ang susunod na hakbang ay maaaring tagumpay. The sower goes on sowing, even if he knows that not all seeds will fall on good soil. Let us be like the sower. Does not give up. Does not stop. Amen.
Please stand.
Let us tell God of our desire for a rich harvest on earth as we reflect on some of the poor soil in our lives, as we say, Lord, make our lives fruitful.
Lord, make our lives fruitful.
That the church may produce a rich harvest in the dedicated and committed lives of her ministers, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, make our lives fruitful,
that a harvest of justice may spring from the selfless labors of government officials, legislators, and judges. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, make our lives fruitful,
that farmers and those who work in the field may reap the fruits of their labor and contribute to the welfare of the community. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, make our lives fruitful,
that the sick and those beset by life's misfortunes may be consoled by the harvest of encouragement from their community and friends. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, make our lives fruitful,
that the faithful departed may come to their everlasting home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, make our lives fruitful.
Loving Father, help us to bring to harvest whatever seeds you have already sown in our hearts. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy, as you blessed the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him, through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Monsignor Severino, whom you have called today from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
As one family, with one common Father in heaven, we pray through the prayers Jesus, through the words Jesus gave us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Tonight I invite you to join the regular Wednesday family rosary that will be hosted by the parish of Santa Rita de Casia in Binagbag, Angat, Bulacan. That will be at 9 o'clock in the evening. And I would like to thank our liturgical ministers who came, you know, in spite of the weather. Sister Ao, Sister Eloisa, Brother Dado, Paeng, and made sure that we have readers and lay ministers and organists. So maraming salamat sa inyo. And to all of you who came here, when you go back to your places, please be careful. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.